here for the last couple of weeks. I've been going quite deep into an internal process of release and healing and letting go. A lot's being stirred up within my beingness. And then from the space of awareness, noticing even more deeply when there is a lot coming up. And a lot of people have experienced this with this new moon in Scorpio that just passed. Ruler of water and emotion, that there was a lot coming up. A lot of people that I've spoken to, a lot of my friends, have been experiencing the same thing. There's like a shit ton of stuff releasing. But then, as always, the invitation is to, rather than try to change or alter the experience, is to welcome everything as it is and to simultaneously recognize that who you are at your core, in your depth, is freedom itself. There is a value in trying to, not trying, there is a value in consciously choosing gratitude, choosing joy, choosing bliss, choosing the excitement of life and seeing what is good and what is beautiful and what is magnificent. But if that is coming from a space of trying to push against something that is occurring in your experience, then that is going to be like a shiny, glossy compensation at best. And so when something arises within you that feels like it's really strong, like an ocean wave within you that's really strong, something that really arises within you, the invitation I want to extend to you today is to welcome that with love and with tenderness. And so in the same way that we often wish that we had a partner who says, hey babe, you can feel all of this and I still love you. That's exactly the kind of relationship that is so beautiful that we cultivate within ourselves, where it's like, my love for you is not fucking conditional. It's not that if you show up in this way, and in this way, and in this way, then you can have my love. But it's like, no matter what happens, I love you and I'm here for you. And that doesn't go anywhere. And if you've been doing your inner work or inner play in this kind of way, and you're moving into intimacy, you'll notice that that also reflects the kind of partner that you tend to attract into your life, the kind of people that you tend to attract into your life. The more you have this unscrew-upable relationship within yourself, more light will bring reflections to you that match that. And the more you step into trust of life and into joy and abundance and into the realization how fucking awesome all of this is, that we can actually live that, the more you begin to attract people into your life who vibe on the same level. And so if you have had the experience of wanting to fit in because of what your parents said, or what society says, or what your upbringing says, or what your mind says, notice that when you simply relax open as the fullness of everything that you are, you will naturally come into contact with people who match that resonance, who jive together. And so your job is not to try and fit in with all of those crazy ideas, but your job is simply to tune into who you are when you are your most natural open self, and just be that. And watch how your soul family and your vibe tribe just comes into your existence. And I was speaking with a woman today, and she was sharing about how she feels like she should be able to just do it all alone. And then I said to her, just you notice that actually that whole idea of I should be able to do it alone, that actually comes from, it's founded in a belief in separation. That it's me and myself and I should be able to do it alone, that actually comes from a fear-based sense of separation. When in fact, the truth of the matter is that there is just one of us here anyway, so it doesn't fucking matter. And so when we realize that, then we can enjoy this flow of both being together with ourselves, which is simply existence experiencing itself in this particular vehicle, enjoy that alone time and feel togetherness with all of life. And you can also, just checking that the camera still stays standing, and you can also really enjoy the feeling of being together with another self or many other selves, and just knowing that it's simply infinity meeting yourself anyways. It doesn't really fucking matter, but it's fun to play in this way, right? Okay, so where I'm at right now, I'm just about now, in 2 days, gonna fly to Hawaii, gonna meet up with my beloved man, and fly to Hawaii and meet up with Jeff and Ryan and Lisa and all of our DJs and musicians for the Ecstatic Awakening Retreat. And so if you see this before the 29th of November 2017, then you can come and join us in Hawaii. And maybe you're halfway around the world, maybe there's a flight you can get on tomorrow. Maybe you are on the Hawaiian Islands and then you can just come and join us. Space is open for both the entire retreat as well as the dance classes. And the dance, make no mistake, is a journey in and of itself. We're going to be guiding embodied bliss workshops every single dance, and it's going to be going deeper and deeper and deeper through that in a deep and yet very playful way, really beautiful way. And our musicians and our DJs that are coming in are absolutely world class and fucking out of this world, exquisite. So the fun, beautiful thing that's happening for the first time here as well is kind of like almost like a jam session. Emergence that's gonna go down in Hawaii. So the first night we're gonna have shamans being played, and Porangi is gonna be doing live instruments and vocals together with us. The second night we're gonna have Liquid Bloom play, and Porangi is gonna be doing instruments and live vocals, and Sabrina Love in shaman's dream is gonna be doing live percussion. And then the third, I forget exactly the schedule, but then we also have Kaminanda playing and Trevor Moon Tribe, and then one evening we have both Kaminanda and Desert Dwellers in a kind of double ecstatic dance wave of cow and bliss and opening and deepening awareness. Also noticing that even in the midst of intense movement, there's always the stillness here that unites all of us. And even as we're still, there is this life force and this vibration that vibrates through all of us. And on our very last dance, on December 6th, we're going to have multi-instrumentalist and musical shaman, Porangi, who is going to be taking us on a journey. Porangi is from Brazil, and I saw him play the first time at Organic Touch Festival. Almost all these people, let's see. Yeah, all of them played the big stages at Oregon Eclipse Festival, and I saw Porangi for the first time. That's where we met the first time, and I was like, man, that was one of the most insanely beautiful musical experiences of my life when he played. And so I invited him to come and play for the Ecstatic Awakening Retreat, and that's what we're going to be experiencing for the first time in Ecstatic Awakening this time around. So Sabrina Love is playing for the first time in Ecstatic Awakening, and Trevor Namani and the Spoilers, Liquid Bloom, Trevor Moon Tribe and Kaminanda are playing for the, I don't know, I forget now, it's like the second, third, fourth time they're playing. We're having people flying from all over the world to join it, so it's going to be beyond amazing. Okay. Okay, so it's getting more and more wet, it's getting more and more dark. I feel the call to go into the ocean. One piece of advice for the rest of your life: follow your resonance, follow your guidance, follow whatever feels like the most expansive, opening, inspiring, maybe even crazy idea. Whatever calls you, that is that guidance, that inspiration. And I'll see you on the dance floor, on a volcano, in the ocean. After the Ecstatic Awakening Retreat, we'll also go and dive with dolphins over on the other side of Hawaii. So if you're hanging around for a few days after the retreat, you can come and swim with dolphins with us.